Cheers, mate.
What are you having for tea tonight? I'll tell you what you're having for tea. It's a microwave meal that's going to go for dinghy in your 6.4 cell.
Congratulations, you'll be tight. So you're now under arrest, okay?
Get away, mate.
Yeah.
You tried to sneak into any crash without me.
Reading Festival. One of the UK's largest festivals with big name acts from across the globe flocking to the stage. A long weekend full of music, booze and comedy. And this year, the one and only Liam Gallagher was headlining. And I had to meet him. Now, I should start by giving you a bit of context. I pulled off a similar stunt 3 years ago and snuck into a music festival as a bin man, went backstage and met Noel Gallagher from Oasis. So could I put my past experiences into practice and meet Liam Gallagher as well? Not exactly.
So this is the story about how I got arrested and spent 7 hours in a cell in police custody. Now it all started when I seen that Liam Gallagher would be headlining the Sunday night at Reading Festival. Now by the time that I found this out, tickets to the event were already sold out. So I thought that I'd put my previous experiences to the test and give it a go on one of the biggest festivals in the UK. Now, an orange hi-vis and a bin bag weren't going to cut it this time, as the security was going to be nuts. So I had to think outside the box a bit. I'd done a bit of research and found one of the steward's hi-vises on Google, which had all of the numbers and credentials on it. I also got tipped off on what all the wristbands looked like as well. So I wasted no time and took a trip to Hobbycraft and ordered a load of crap off of Amazon for next day delivery. And after everything had all arrived, it was time to incriminate my nan and get her to give me a hand with making this disguise.
So we're just on the way to my nan's house now. Got all the stuff in the back. She's gonna help us do the hi-vis. And then maybe he'll give us a hand doing the wristbands as well. Nan has come to the rescue. Has mum told you what? I'm gonna make the numbers. Because they're 4-digit numbers. I'm gonna make them 1169. Because I thought, I'm taking the piss enough as it is already, so why not take the piss even more?
If you really do want to get in, I wouldn't be doing any piss take. I'd try and keep it as original as possible.
Yeah.
And with that solid advice there from June, she lent me her prize stencil, to which I headed back to carry on making the disguise.
Time for a montage.
I'm not even going to bother steps in this one. If I can just burn them together, then I'm laughing.
Size of this bee, mind. Bloody hell. He's a unit, mate. Oh my god. Go out. Leave.
So after consulting my best mate Dave, I could confirm that was actually a wasp. Anyway, with the distraction out of the way, it's time for one more cheesy montage.
Oh, right, that is one strip complete. So the time is now 11:30. It's down to the wire, but it's got to be done. This is literally just taking liberties, mate. What? Right, I think we're ready. Got the wristband on now. It's not looking too bad. It's all right. Could be a bit better, but it's turned out okay. We got the COVID one, which I think is the COVID one. I'm not so sure. Nice little QR code that I've drawn there. And this monstrosity here went a bit mad with the Tipex, but yeah, fingers crossed.
Look at this creation, mate. Phenomenal bits of arts and crafts work.
So with everything all set, it was time to get suited and booted. But there's just one slight problem.
Basically left my boots outside for ages, and there's like a fuck off spider living inside them now.
Oh my god. Oh my lordy lord.
So with the eight-legged distraction out of the way, I got in the car and headed down to Reading. When I arrived, I parked the car in a car park and started getting everything I needed together.
Right, I've got the wristbands on. They actually don't look too bad, to be fair.
I then put everything I needed inside a black bin liner and began following the crowd down to the festival. It was now time to get changed into my disguise.
So as I got geared up, the nerves began to set in. I had to be confident now. I began scouting out the festival to decide which entrance that I would go through. I settled on going through the red one. I slowly approached the gates. But would my disguise work?
No.
Excuse me.
And then this happened.
Oh, it's good, isn't it? It's alright, isn't it?
It's not like that. No, mate, I coloured you straight away, mate. It's close. If you'd gone orange,
Orange.
It'd have been alright.
I've got it.
It's alright, isn't it?
He's in the band. Yeah,
he's done it all himself.
Yeah,
it's radio on.
Can you let me in for effort?
I wish we could.
No, mate.
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to have to search, yeah?
That's fine, right, yeah.
That's brilliant, mate.
Oh, no, hour and a half choice. I thought it would work. Mate,
when did you realise I'd collared you?
I sort of was like, this guy isn't stupid. Like,
are
like,
you on like YouTube or something?
Yeah.
Is it still going?
Yeah. this guy. Oh, no.
So the security were actually so sound about the whole situation. They were there taking pics of me, taking the piss out of me, the lot.
Just grabbing a photo of the wristband. What do you make of it?
10 out of 10 for effort, pal, that's what I will say. Are we taking the wristband here?
Yes.
Sorry, pal.
That's all right, mate, no worries.
You got a lot further than the last guy, though. I even got the numbers on there and everything. He's done good. It's a good effort.
He did well, man.
Try not to damage you here.
That's all right, mate, yeah, no worries. One more, mate.
Oh, look, he's in there. The guy's drawn a QR code. Like, this is some effort to get in.
Oh, mate.
One more, man.
No way. Oh, mate. He's sick. Yeah, I'm top rating and stuff. No.
Hot box events as well.
Yeah, look at the tip bags, mate.
No.
You're a legend. Thanks, man.
Nah, real talk.
Sound, mate.
You did well, so I'm not even gonna lie.
But this is the light of my life, like the plastic walkie talkie. It's made my weakness, bro. Yeah, right. You're good to put your stuff. Oh, nearly gave you them back.
Oh, you said I could keep the walkie.
Yeah, you can keep the plastic walkie.
Sound, mate.
So after they'd searched me and confiscated what they needed to, they then escorted me off the premises.
Escorted me out.
Wait a minute. Yeah.
He picked a legend
number. Yes,
mate. 69.
Sal.
Goodbye,
mate.
The guy. What's your name, mate?
Mark.
Mark, you're a G.
All right, mate. See you later.
Number one man.
See you next year.
See you next year.
Hello, mate.
Hiya, mate.
How's it going?
Yeah, not bad.
10 out of 10 for effort, bud.
You know you're being recorded at the moment.
That's fine, yeah.
Okay. So, obviously, we've had information that you've got a card reader on you.
So at this point I was really confused. They basically mistaken me for another person, but luckily my guy was on hand to help me out.
No, this is our gentleman that's just trespassing. He's come on.
Trespassing?
But yeah, this is fake wristbands.
Do you know where a card reader do this?
The next guy's up there, I believe, with the response team. Right. This guy's just walking off site.
You can leave him.
No worries, thank you very much.
It's your lucky day, actually.
See you, Benny, you've had a good one.
Cheers.
Good effort. So, mate. Next
So as I headed back into the crowd, this time with the festival goers facing towards me, you're probably sat there thinking, how'd you actually get arrested then? They've just let you go. Well, I think the easiest thing to do is just carry on watching.
Well, that couldn't have gone any worse. Luckily, they let me keep a lot of the shit, so like the mitten picker, the radio, and like my earpiece. They took the hi-vis off and they took the bands away from me. But I've got more red bands in the car and I've got another hi-vis in the car, so we're gonna give it another go. This probably is a bad idea, I should, at this point, should just be listening to my gut and saying, George, just quit, but
I want to watch Liam Gallagher. I want to go in and see my mates and prove everyone wrong, so we're going to do it.
A gut feeling. An instinctive feeling as opposed to an opinion based on facts. And I decided to ignore mine and headed back to the car to give it another go.
Right, we got the wristbands. I don't know if I've got anything in here. That's a whiteboard marker, a pen. I could do something with that, to be fair. Seeing as they're white on that, I don't think I've got any Tippex in here. Didn't bring any. Oh, fucking, yeah, I did. Ah, Nin. Right, okay. We'll try and make another band. And we've got the orange high-vis. This one's got a pocket on it as well. They let us keep the radio, let us keep everything else. We've got the litter picker. I've got some more bags as well. So happy days. Mark, the very kind security guard, has told us that I'd be better off going in with an orange one.
Have you gone orange?
So thanks for the heads up, Mark. I am going to do an orange one now. So, you know, let's go for round two, see if you can catch me. And yeah, right. I had to rush it. I'm against the clock now. So this is what I'm going to be going in with, and an orange high vis and a layer picker. If I get in with this, fuck me.
So I headed back down once again with my new master plan and tried it one last time.
Give it another go.
With my new disguise, I managed to get through the first phase of security.
And then it all went wrong.
What are you having for tea tonight? I'll tell you what you're having for tea. It's a microwave meal that's going to go ba-ding in your 6.4 cell.
So what are you doing now?
I just want to give it another go.
Yeah. Okay, congratulations, you're detained. Goods or services by fraud, contrary to Fraud Act 2006. Section 2, fraud by false representation. So you're now under arrest, okay? He needs Nicky.
So as I got escorted off the festival grounds with my marvellous creation being dangled just an arm's reach away from me, I then got slung into the back of a car and driven down to the local police station, where I'd then spend the next 7 hours in a cell.
Now, when I was in the car, the song When the Going Gets Tough by Billy Ocean was playing the whole journey.
Yeah, this is a
and I couldn't help just sit there and think that the going was definitely fucking tough for me right now. However, by the end of the song, we'd arrived at the police station. Now, the police station wasn't actually a police station. It was a leisure centre that they pimped out whilst the festival was going on. So I ended up going there first.
What I'm going to do, mate, is I'm going to search you, because you might have other items that you might be using for, whatever reason you're using for. Have you got anything in your pocket?
So at this point, I had to stop recording because the police were about to search me. I emptied out all of my pockets and they then read out my rights, placed me under arrest and then put me in handcuffs. I then got taken down into this room inside the leisure centre, police station. My mouth was like really dry, so I asked if I could have a drink of water. I was still in handcuffs at this point, so one of the officers had to get a bottle and put it to my mouth. And I literally got like the smallest sip, but it went down the wrong way. So I just started like choking in front of all of these officers going like, looking like such a wet wipe. They then uncuffed me and took me into another room where they started getting some more information off of me. They were asking all the basic stuff like, what's your name, date of birth, have you been arrested before? And then they asked, do you have any allergies? Now, the answer to that would be, no, don't have any allergies. But for some reason, I told the lady that I don't like cheese. Anyway, they then took me into the back of a police van to take me down to the actual police station. I got put in the little box thing at the back, no seatbelt, and then suddenly we hit a road that had like half a mile worth of speed bumps. And the officer driving was not slowing down for these whatsoever. Now, I'm quite a lanky guy, and I don't weigh much, So after every bump that he did, I would literally smash my head off the roof of the van. But I'm surprised I didn't get a concussion by the end of the trip. So after the agonizing journey, we'd finally arrived at the police station and they had to check me in. The guy on the reception desk just started asking for my date of birth, things like that. And then he was like, "Is it George?" I was like, yeah, that's me. And then he went, "You don't like cheese?" They'd actually put on my police file that I don't like cheese. And then all these officers around me were just howling out with laughter. But as if I haven't been mugged off enough already today, I then got taken into my cell where I had to spend the next 7 hours inside. Now, it's not fun and it's very, very boring. I pretty much just slept the entire time. And finally, after hours upon end, I got a knock on the cell door to take me in for my interview. The policewoman interviewing me was absolutely lovely. She then started asking if I had any accomplices that had helped me. To which I basically just grasped up my nan and told her that she'd help me. Sorry nan for throwing you under the bus, but we're going down for this together. She then started putting some evidence in front of me. Now whilst I was in the cell, thanks to my security mate telling the police I had 100 wristbands in my car, they went and searched it. I've still got hundreds of these wristbands, so if anyone wants one, just comment below and I'll post one out to you. I don't want them anymore. Anyway, they found the wristbands, a bin bag full of high vises, and my nan's stencil that she lent me. Unfortunately, it all got seized as evidence and is now being destroyed, so sorry Nan about your stencil. Anyway, she concluded the interview and then went and made me a hot chocolate. And then soon after that, I was free. She gave me this mint jumper and then organised some officers to drive me back down to the Leisure Centre to get my belongings and then drop me off to my car. And this was my final goodbyes with the Thames Valley Police Force.
There we go. Thank you very much for the kind lift.
No problem.
I won't
safe
do it again.
Journey back to Bristol, don't yeah. do it again.
Cheers, mate.
In big trouble with your parents.
Yeah. What a day. Cheers.
Now, I really don't recommend that you try this. I got off lightly, and I'd just like to apologise for wasting everyone's time whilst I've done this stunt. Anyway, that was that. If you enjoyed watching this video, then please leave a like rating and a comment below. And if you liked what you saw, then why not subscribe? And I might make some more videos in the future. Who knows? Thank you very much for watching. Cheers.